Miami is a really unique place. And it's really, really tied to the coast. We like to live next to the water. And with all of that, we are uniquely vulnerable to climate change.
Another massive hurricane has hit Florida in the early hours of this morning.
We see hurricanes and storms that intensify more rapidly. The temperature is increasing, and we have sea level rise.
We have taken out a lot of the natural ecosystems and infrastructure, and that has increased our vulnerability. So if we do not protect our coastline, it will cost trillions of dollars in the U.S. This is going to happen across the globe. But we need to find solutions.
We're trying to design something that is inspired by nature, something that will be sustainable and also efficient. Wave force can really destroy our structures. Even small waves of 4 cubic feet of water is approximately 260 pounds. That is also the average weight of an NFL football player. And of course, a wave is not one player, it's a large amount of players coming again and again. We need something like a speed bump in the highway, slowing down the energy of the waves, protecting the coastline. Traditional shoreline protection structures sometimes overpower nature, and they tend to bounce back the wave energy rather than dissipate it. And they also do not provide habitat.
One of the most exciting pieces of new technology in South Florida is SeaHives.
When we started SeaHive, we were trying to integrate nature and create solutions that do not only bounce back the energy, but actually absorb part of the energy. The hexagonal pattern that we use, the beehive, is inspired by the bees so that we can optimize the material use, but also create something which is very stable and efficient in terms of the energy dissipation. In Miami Beach, we're working with corals. Here in Wahoo Bay, we're working with mangroves.
The SeaHive is intended to be not only a system for coastal protection, but a living laboratory. It can turn into an artificial reef, but it can also support the growth of coastal plants. Historically, Miami has two powerful ecosystems, coral reefs and mangroves. They offer a first line of protection against waves, against storms. They break the energy from the ocean, but these ecosystems facing many threats, not only in Florida, but globally. And this can be development, the construction of roads, aquaculture, conversion for agriculture. Sometimes we don't have the time that is required for natural regeneration of the forest. So we need to intervene.
So our installation is basically a series of sea hives that are put together, stacked in a pyramid or a little bit trapezoidal there. And we provide the substrate, a first line of defense for the corals and mangroves while well established.
The way that we planted the mangroves was very easy. We fill this with gravel at the bottom. Then there is a combination of sand and organic soil. And then on top, we deposited more gravel to stabilize the soil.
Mangroves dissipate wave energy. It's the roots that are going to pick up and create that complex structure. There is a component there with the empty space inside those sea hives that will allow the mangroves to pick up. You can see fish living. There's a lot of things there that might find a home here. We also try to capture carbon as mangroves will attract and store some of the CO2. Hybrid solutions provide, if properly designed, the best out of both worlds. So they provide us a structure which is established quite fast, and then with an added layer of performance coming from nature.
Mm-hmm.
Our installation in Miami Beach is working with corals. In the laboratory setting, we tested different types of corals. We tested staghorn corals and boulder corals and combinations of the two. We realized that staghorn corals, the ones that look like trees with all the branches, can dissipate more wave energy because of their structure, while the boulder corals are stronger. So we have a combination of staghorn and boulder corals that will allow us to dissipate energy. We saw that just the skeletons can provide up to 60% more wave energy dissipation than the bare reef structures. We have projects that we reached 75%, 85%. Of course, here we have a pilot. This pilot can be scaled up in terms of the width, the height, and also the depth here can really provide a template that we can use in other places so that we can do infrastructure projects that integrate in nature.
We know that it will cost over $3 trillion by 2100 if we do not adapt. And it's really, really important that we get this financing right. One of the key components of SeaHive is that they are proving natural coastal protections are self-repairing. In the long run, it's cheaper to invest in nature-based solutions because you don't have to do the same kind of maintenance that you would have to do with just gray infrastructure that will rot out over a certain amount of time.
What is critical here is that we have the performance of the SeaHive as a system, because then we can go to the stakeholders and talk about the green interventions.
We can bring it to the financiers and say, look, this is where we should spend our money.
Projects like this allow us to see the performance in real-world conditions. SeaHive as a system is versatile, so the solution is transferable all around the world.
You could take a SeaHive from here and put it in New York and use it for protection with oysters.
We live in cities by the water. Over 40% of the global population living near the coastline. Nature there is the reason that we established our position, but also is one of our allies in protecting us. It's critical that we start acting now and we start interfering in a way that is impactful.